In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, who created us and who sustain us in being, and who accord to each person particular gifts, through whose use we give glory to you, send your Holy Spirit upon our graduands this afternoon, who have completed courses in the Department of Sport, Health and Nutrition, to strengthen them to embrace the challenges of the future, so that they may each contribute through the qualifications which they have gained to the building up of the civilization of love in your world, which Christ your Son came to inaugurate. We ask this through the same Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, graduands, guests and staff, I now declare the ceremony open. I invite the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Margaret House, to give her welcome address.
Chancellor, Chair of the Board of Governors, distinguished guests, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, and especially you, our graduands. Welcome to this, the first of our 2015 graduation ceremonies. It's my pleasure and honour to congratulate you on your success in graduating from Leeds Trinity University. Today we recognise the achievements of you, our newest graduands. It's time of joy after much hard work and dedication, a day that everyone at Leeds Trinity looks forward to with pride. For you, our graduands, this ceremony marks the completion of your studies and the beginning of fresh challenges. We share in your excitement and wish you luck in your future. What you have achieved should not be underestimated. You had to work hard to earn your place on your chosen degree program, competing against many others for your university place. Whilst gaining your place at university was an achievement in itself, once you arrived at university, the hard work really began. Intellectually and mentally demanding, studying for a degree requires a great deal of hard work, perseverance, and determination. But you've done it. Today is your day to celebrate. You thoroughly deserve your success, and I hope you feel as proud of yourselves as we do of you. Graduation is a very special occasion, giving you the chance to reflect on and to celebrate your achievements. But of course, this isn't goodbye. Leeds Trinity is your university, and we'll be here for you whenever you need us, when your skills need refreshing, when you're ready for the next academic challenge. And indeed, at this ceremony, I'm delighted to say that we'll be awarding Bill Hart with his foundation degree in professional coaching in Lishi Movement. Bill is 90 years young, and as such, Bill, I believe that you are our oldest ever graduate and a clear advocate of lifelong learning. Many congratulations to you, and thank you for studying at Leeds Trinity University. As a Leeds Trinity graduate, your future is bright and your opportunities are boundless. Be confident and ambitious. Whether you have your future already mapped out, or whether you're pausing before deciding what comes next, I believe we've prepared you well to work hard, to work well with others, and to take pride and enjoyment from work and study. Today is also a special day for your guests, and I'm delighted to see so many guests here today to join in your celebration. Parents, carers, grandparents, husbands, wives, partners, friends, children, teachers. You've all been there for our graduands throughout their entire journey, a journey which started long before Leeds Trinity University, and a journey which may continue for some to postgraduate study and research. Your contribution to their success has been invaluable, regardless of the ways in which you have supported our graduands. I would like to personally thank each and every one of you for always being there for our graduands during their time at Leeds Trinity University. And I'm now going to ask the graduands if they would stand, face their family and friends, and join with me in showing your appreciation for all their support. I have to say that doesn't sound terribly grateful. Come on, you could do better than that. Thank you. I'm honoured to also be sharing the stage with another group of people here today who have played a significant role in your success. These are my colleagues, your lecturers and tutors, who've been there for you throughout your degree, supporting you and providing you with knowledge and inspiration. I'd also like to thank our support staff, without whom the delivery of your degree programmes, or indeed events like today, would not be possible. I'm incredibly proud of the academic and support staff here at Leeds Trinity University. They work hard to ensure your success, and this time I would like to ask the staff to stand, including those that are in the auditorium, and those staff in the atrium, if you would come in and join us. And this time I would like you graduands to join with me in showing our appreciation. Has spent with us here have been a time of great achievement for Leeds Trinity. This year, our quinquennial review undertaken by the Quality Assurance Agency resulted in the affirmation of our quality and standards. The outcome from the 6-yearly Research Excellence Framework exercise reported our research in communications, media and culture and English language and literature to be world leading. This year, we opened the Trinity Enterprise Centre, a new facility to foster students' entrepreneurial and business skills. And Ben Lawton, one of our final year students, was awarded the Duke of York Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award. In November, we launched Leeds Children's University, and in May, appointed English midfielder James Milner as our first Chancellor. Leeds Children's University aims to provide life choices for children available in the Leeds area between the ages of 7 and 14. And we are grateful to our staff and students who, through volunteering, support many of the extracurricular activities offered to the children. We are committed to providing the highest standards of learning and academic excellence to our students. Last year, over 95% of our graduates were in work or further study 6 months after completing their studies. For the second year in a row, a record number of students, you, achieved first and upper second class awards, and student satisfaction with their course at Leeds Trinity University once again exceeded the national average, according to the latest results from the National Student Survey. In addition, the Guardian University Guide ranked us as second in the UK for student satisfaction with assessment and feedback. We're especially proud of these last two figures as they're accolades bestowed upon us by you, our graduands. As a result of these achievements, the university climbed 27 places in the Guardian University Guide, and we were ranked 28th out of more than 100 universities in a recent What Uni compilation of top universities. We're incredibly proud of these successes from across the university, many of which have been contributed to by you, our graduating students. We recognize that you are graduating in a challenging economic climate, a climate of substantial change. However, as Leeds Trinity University graduates, you have enormous opportunities waiting for you. Your degree has provided you with both knowledge and highly sought after skills. In addition, the vocational focus of your courses has given you the best possible opportunity to be ready for the world of work. But degrees aren't just about gaining academic skills and becoming employable. Throughout your time with us, you've gained independence, developed as individuals, and made friends for life. You may even have met your future partner. These achievements are just as important as the academic merits of a degree, and I'm sure I speak for everyone here when I say it's been a pleasure to watch you develop and grow into inspiring individuals with very bright futures ahead of you. Leeds Trinity University may be less than 50 years old, but in that time we've achieved a great deal. These achievements are the results of a successful partnership between Leeds Trinity University and you, our graduands, soon to be alumni. We can only sustain our success by continuing to recruit outstanding students like you, with the potential to achieve what you've achieved here today. And you should feel very proud of the role that you've played in Leeds Trinity University's success. Today we're celebrating the success of you, our 2015 graduands. Everyone at Leeds Trinity appreciates that life is far from easy for today's students. Learning is a personal challenge. All of you will have faced your own particular challenges, and all of you have overcome them. Your family and friends will have supported you. Many of you will have had to work to pay your way through your studies. All of you will have had to make sacrifices to ensure your success. It is therefore with enormous pride that everyone here at Leeds Trinity sees your success today. I am sure that family and friends here share in my delight at the achievements of you, our 2015 graduates. You are all exceptional people. Congratulations, well done, and good luck.
The conferment of the awards for our graduands. I invite Dr. Julie Brunton to present awards from the Department of Sport, Health and Nutrition.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, I am pleased to present the following. For the award of Foundation Degree of Arts in Professional Coaching of Leisure Movement, I present Willoughby Hart. Keegan. For the award of Bachelor of Arts in Physical Education Primary and Sports Development, I present Kate Adams. Lois Elizabeth Cartledge. Christopher Chapman. Joshua Clough. Elizabeth Dodd. Jordan Lazenby. Kelly Morgan. Robert Minett. Roman Rajanovic. Nicholas Smithers. Gemma Stones. Anna Anthony Thewlis. Andrew Thompson. Emily Wade. Misbah Waheed. Sean Westman. For the award of Bachelor of Arts in Sport, Physical Education and Health, I present Nicola Beresford. Simon Clemison. For the award of Bachelor of Arts in Sports Development and Physical Education, I present Frances Anion. Amy Backhouse. Helena Bell. Daniel Balinfanti. James Clapham. Tom Copping. Thomas Crampton. Bridie Kirbishley. Angela Chernick Pattinson. Joseph Edwards. Lucy Farrer. Kate Elizabeth Green. Amy Horsfield. Oliver James. Liam Miller. Reese Murgatroyd. Peter Newband. Thomas Parry. Abigail Potts. Craig Robertshaw. Riley Shaw. Rebecca Simonitis. Keith Stevenson. Carla Vincent. Tara Walker. Adam Wellington. Jonathan Wilson. Christopher Wright. For the award of Bachelor of Science in Nutrition and Food, I present Nicola Ariara. Glenn Freelove. Catherine Razor. Kimberly Sykes. Kirsty Womack. For the award of Bachelor of Science in Sport and Exercise Psychology, I present Paul Dutton. Benjamin Gibson. Jack Hutchinson. Oliver Morby. Megan Owens. Connor Phillips. Benjamin Wood. For the award of Bachelor of Science in Sport, Health, Exercise, Nutrition, I present Kasim Abbas. Christopher Adams. Hassan Ahmed. Matthew Attle. Scott Everdale. Georgina Hack. Ben Hardman. Tom Hennigan. Katie Holland. Samuel Jones. Jake Loughran. Kate Mahoney. Emily McAfee. Ross McTernan. Callum Pashley. Ashley Powell. Bianca Richmond. Thomas Roberts. Ashley Robinson. Tyrone Saunders. Amy Schofield. James Shave. Samantha Smith. Aaron Smithson. Adam Walshaw. Keely Westerman. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the presentation of awards from the Department of Sport, Health and Nutrition.
Vice-Chancellor, Dr. Brunton will now present prize winners from the department.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, I present the following graduates who are also recipients of the Sport Health Nutrition Department Prize. Helena Bell. Paul Dutton. Katie Holland. And Kirsty Womack. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the presentation of the prizes from the department.
Phew! I bet you're all massively relieved, especially some of the girls who are in 6-inch heels, that that's all over with. There was a chap I noticed who wouldn't have got into the Royal Box at Wimbledon on Sunday, because he had no socks on. Yes, I'm talking to you. But we're a little bit more loose here, I feel, than the Royal Box. I don't know if you know, Lewis Hamilton was turned away from Wimbledon, but personally, I think it looks a good look. I liked it. I like the shoes. He's giving me a very hard look now. I genuinely did think you looked fantastic. In fact, you all look fantastic. You all look healthy, well, vibrant, and like you want to go out and attack the next phase of your life, which is so good, because that's what you're going to have to do, because the hard work has been done to a certain extent, but more hard work starts from here. But first of all, Mr. Crompton, was it Mr. Crompton? Where are you? There you are, sir. And Mr. Bell, well done. Most vocal parents at every graduation, there are some that whoop and holler more, and that was fantastic, because you guys, without you guys, they wouldn't be here. Your support, your love, your energy, your commitment towards them in times where things have got a bit tough, absolutely vital. Nobody can do it without the love and support and guidance of family around them. And one of the things that appealed to me about Trinity when I was honoured enough and honoured to be asked to take the position of Chancellor was that it's a university with a rich tradition in pioneer students, which means students who come from a family where nobody's been to university before. And I was from a family like that. When I went to university, I was the first person in my family to go to university. And I know that a lot of students here might be the first person in their families, whether it's their siblings might have gone, but perhaps their parents haven't. And so it's a voyage of discovery for all of us when you embark on that. And I was minded of that a few weeks ago when I was given an honorary doctorate from my university, Durham. And I went back to collect the doctorate and I sat in Durham Cathedral and I looked out and realized that it was 20 years since I graduated. 20 years since I sat in your position. I'm not quite sure whether the speakers are doing that right now. Maybe it's because they're shocked that it's that long since I graduated. And 20 years goes in the blink of an eye, let me tell you. It literally goes in a heartbeat. I couldn't believe when I sat there and thought about it that it's been such a long time. When I graduated, we just about had mobile phones. We didn't use the internet for anyone. We went to libraries because that was the only way that we could actually achieve any kind of knowledge, because we didn't have the internet, we didn't have Wi-Fi. I had an old-fashioned word processor, but I only got that in my third year. In the first 2 years, I used to send my work back to my mum, who had a secretary, and I'd pay her to type up my essays, because I wasn't very good at typing. And yet, this is only 20 years ago. So much has changed in 20 years, and so much will change in the next 20 years for all of you. Things will move very quickly, technology will move very quickly, and our lives have to adapt and move in a fast-paced way. I remember when somebody first introduced me to the internet, I thought, this will never catch on. This is a waste of time. I can't believe anybody's thinking of actually achieving knowledge this way. And now we take it for granted that we gain our knowledge in this way. So you've got so much ahead of you, so many exciting things that you have in store. And is there anything I can do to stop that noise? If somebody gives me an indication, I can stop moving, breathing, anything? Because it's It's vaguely annoying, isn't it? And I'm not sure what it is, but if you just give me a clue, anybody, I will stop doing whatever it is I'm doing to exacerbate it. Otherwise, I'll carry on regardless. And so I thought about the kind of things that I wish somebody had told me, the tools that you need in your working life and if you want to go on and achieve great things professionally and also personally as well, because let's not forget that there's no point being brilliant and owning a company and making millions and being the best in your career if your personal life is an absolute load of rubbish, because the most important thing, as you all, I'm sure, realise and your families will know, is what's at home, your family and your support systems and the people that you love. So the first thing that I would say that you need to have is love. And that means love for what you do, a passion for what you do, kindness in what you do. When you meet somebody in your life, you never know if you're going to meet them again. And they might not meet you again, and the impression they have from you might be that one moment. And if you don't leave them with a sense of kindness and with a sense that you've given them a little bit of generosity of spirit, they will never know that you had that in you. And I think in your professional lives, that will be so important, because while we are very much kind of directed towards tablets and computer screens, we shouldn't forget the importance of human relations and interacting with each other. And your love and passion for what you do is so contagious. When I meet people who are passionate about what they do, it just leaves me with such an enormous spring in my step, because it is very contagious, that passion and that love. And nobody ever feels they've gone to work if they love what they do. I sometimes catch myself saying I'm going to work and actually berate myself, because I realise I'm incredibly lucky to do a job that I adore, and I love the people that I work with. And it never really feels like work, even on the most disappointing days where it's raining and you're stood on a pitch somewhere covered in mud and you can't get the interview you want and things aren't going particularly well and the technology breaks down. But even on those days, I realise I'm incredibly lucky. So always do something that fills you with passion. Don't persist with something if you haven't got love and passion for it, because ultimately that'll just wane away and you'll be wasting your time. You really need to get hold of something that you love and something that you adore. And you work towards that, you strive towards that. So love and passion, I think, is really, really important. Perseverance is incredibly important. Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up on your goals. You may think that didn't work out for me, but it may work out tomorrow. It may work out the next day. Don't just put it to one side. If it's a real dream, if it's a real goal, you will achieve it, and it will be all the better for it. Having those failures, having those disappointments actually make you so much stronger and make you so much more resilient and better equipped to achieve. I'm so lucky in the job that I do. I meet some incredible sports people who have gone through all kinds of stories of perseverance and trying again and failing and then getting back up again. And I remember after the Olympics in 2008, I spent a day with Rebecca Adlington, and she'd won two golds in Beijing. They were quite surprise golds. We kind of weren't expecting her to do as well as she did. And she said, when we were after a couple of months after Beijing, when she had time to reflect, in the year up to Beijing, there wasn't a training session where she didn't get out the pool and she was physically sick. She was pushing her body so hard every time. And she said to me, I thought to myself, if my main competitors are being sick after every training session, well, then they can beat me. They can come close to me. But if they're not, I know I'm pushing myself as hard as I can. That's quite an extreme way of pushing yourself, obviously. I don't want you to be sick every day at work. But you get the message there, that sometimes you've just got to push on harder and harder than the next person to get there. And her perseverance and her passion for what she did as well was tangible. And you could see that there was somebody there who really believed in her goals. She was an ordinary girl from Mansfield. She wasn't somebody who grew up in a swimming family. She wasn't somebody who grew up with an Olympic pool down the road. But she overcame all kinds of obstacles as a kid and achieved her dreams. Bravery is so important as well. You'll be forced to make decisions in your life that are a bit tough, and you put yourself out of your comfort zone. And if you can, do that on a daily or weekly or monthly basis. Do something that makes you feel quite uncomfortable. It might be standing up like this, speaking to a room of people you don't know who are giving you looks back as if to say, sit down, I need to go and have a glass of Prosecco. Well, do it. Stand up and talk to people, because that is a way of conquering your fear for next time, doing something that you feel a little bit uncomfortable about. When I left university, I had a year in Newcastle, and I was offered a job by Sky. And I went down to Sky at 23 years old. I didn't know anybody there. I didn't know anybody in London. And when I look back now, I think I was actually a bit brave to do that, because I was having a really nice time in Newcastle. I had a nice job. I had a nice boyfriend, and life was quite good. But I knew that there was something else out there I wanted to do, and I made that step. And I was discussing this with my husband. He said, getting in a car isn't very brave. I said, no, but moving yourself outside of your comfort zone sometimes is brave. And you don't realize till afterwards that you've taken those little brave steps. So don't be scared to be brave. And don't be scared if it doesn't go quite as the way you planned it, because there'll be another opportunity around the corner. And the other thing that you need to have, I feel, is humour and a sense that you can laugh at yourself when things don't quite go right and have the ability to turn around and say, OK, well, you know, I'm not taking myself too seriously here, because in my job, things go wrong quite regularly. I think if I didn't have that, I probably wouldn't be able to do the job that I do, because it's the kind of job where you publicly get humiliated on a daily basis sometimes, depending on what you're presenting on BBC Sport. But when I was hosting the Olympic Games, I did a show called Olympics Tonight, and we had this fantastic guest list every night. We had all these amazing Olympians would come onto the sofa, and on the very final show we had Michael Johnson, who's the 400 meter record holder. Tom Daley was on there, David Beckham came on the show, Catherine Granger. I had this wonderful guest list last night of the Olympic Games, which had been incredibly successful for the BBC. And during one of the boxing VTs, I turned to David Beckham and I said, this boxer who's won the gold medal, Luke Campbell, sadly his mum and his sister died in a car accident. And David said, quite rightly, that's very sad. And we were discussing how amazing it was he'd overcome that in his life. And we came back to the studio and weren't intending to talk about that, but David decided he wanted to share his emotion about that. And he said, it's very sad that his mum and sister died in a car accident. And we carried on with the show, and we got to the end of the show, and I said goodnight to the viewers. And in my ear, the producer said, go back into the studio. And I thought, oh, well, we've done 18 nights of the show. Being an egomaniacal presenter, they're going to give me a cake and award me with a glass of champagne to say thank you. I went back in the studio, and the monitor was still on. The show was still going. They said, sit down. Luke Campbell's mum and sister are alive and well. Well, yeah, it's good news, obviously. And so I'm then thinking, oh, my goodness, I've committed this terrible mistake on air. Well, actually, I hadn't. David Beckham did. But let's not, you know, split hairs on that one. I thought, what am I going to do? How am I going to do this? And in my ear, they're all arguing about, was it another boxer? Who was it? So I just decided to say, ladies and gentlemen, I'm afraid some erroneous information made it to air tonight. Luke Campbell's mum and sister are alive and well. And that was my last words of the Olympic Games 2012, which was a crushing professional disappointment for me that I'd ended in such a way. But the next day I thought, no, I've got to ring his mum and just apologise. Also, I wanted to check she was indeed alive and well. And I picked up the phone, and I rang her up, and I said, oh, Mrs. Campbell, it's Gabby Logan here from the BBC. She went, oh, yes. Oh, yes, my form was off the hook last night. She's not a Geordie, she's from Hull, but my accent from Hull's not very good. And she said, I had loads of phone calls last night, people wanting to know if I was well, people wanting to know if I was alive. And I said, I know, I'm terribly sorry, it was a terrible mistake. And she said, it's okay, because I came down at breakfast in the hotel this morning, and the whole dining room stood up and started singing Thriller to us. So, you know, you make mistakes, some of them not as gargantuan and embarrassing as that. I didn't sleep that night, admittedly. But you don't make them again, that's the point. You always check on everybody's members of families when you're talking about them on air in the future. So you will make mistakes, but you have to laugh at yourself. It does take time sometimes between that mistake and then being able to laugh about it. But have humour in what you do, and have fun in what you do as well. I know you will, because you've obviously done fantastic degrees, you've got fantastic results, and you've got a wonderful future ahead of you. And this university is a family for you, and it is a constant source of support and encouragement, and you are part of that going forwards forevermore. So I hope you always come back and share your successes and share what you do, because it's really important that you keep feeding through the university. And you may not particularly know somebody who's sat here in this group of people right now, but one day you might come across them. And trust me, when I come across people that I went to university with, there is a bond, there's an instant bond. I was working the other night at an event, and the guy I was talking to, who was working for this bank, Macquarie's, he said, oh, we were at university at the same time. We hadn't been on the same course, but we had a shared experience, and it's a shared experience which you will dip back into, and I hope you'll take forwards forevermore, and you'll remember these days fondly. So good luck with everything, and keep working hard and enjoy it. And thank you so much for representing this university.
For a wonderfully inspiring address. I now invite Lucy Farah, a student of the graduating cohort, to give the vote of thanks.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, academic staff, family, friends, and finally graduates of 2015, good afternoon. When I was first asked to write the speech for the photo thanks on behalf of everyone, I started to collate all the memories that I've built up over the last 3 years, which I can tell you is an awful lot. But I'd like to share with you some of my most powerful ones. When I first came to Leeds Trinity University, I felt a bit overwhelmed and a little bit lost. It was the first time I had properly been away from home, and although I was excited, I was also very nervous. However, like many of you, I was able to rely on the amazing support and friendship of those around me, particularly all my friends from Kirkstall Halls of Residence. I made it through the first week and embarked on a new life at Leeds Trinity. In what seems like a blink of an eye, 3 years have passed, and I am now standing here as a graduate. I can hardly believe it, and it sounds so good. So well done to every single person in this room today. I hope you feel as proud as I do right now. But I think as a graduate is more than just a qualification and a piece of paper. So I stand here not only as a graduate, but also as someone who has grown as an individual, ready and willing to take the next step in life. Each of us have made that journey, and the reason I think we have been successful is down to the never-ending support, guidance, and friendship of the staff and students of Leeds Trinity University. I think I can say on behalf of every Leeds Trinity University graduate sat in front of me that one of the most special things that can be said about this place is that you're not just a nameless face sat in a lecture theatre, you are a real person with a name. It literally used to take me a good half an hour to walk down the corridor on my way to lectures as I was so busy saying hello to everyone. This has made me feel like I've been part of a little family whilst at university, and especially within the Department of Sport, Health and Nutrition. So on behalf of all graduates, I would like to say a massive thank you to all academic and support staff within the department, because without your constant support, help and advice, many of us wouldn't be here today. Leeds Trinity really does give its students more than just a degree. Whilst being here, I've been taught many life lessons and been given so many opportunities, from being a student ambassador and student trustee to playing for a number of university sports teams. Above all, I've learned the importance of hard work, teamwork, and to not give in when times are hard. This graduation ceremony is a testament to how capable we all are at accomplishing our goals when we commit ourselves to them. I hope all of us can take this personal accomplishment as an example of how anything is truly possible when we put our minds to it. Finally, the last thank you I want to say is to everyone back at home. I believe that without our families and close friends providing much needed support, many of us would have found this journey so much tougher. I, for one, am personally grateful for my family and close friends. Without them, getting my degree would have been impossible. So graduates, please find time today to say thank you to those loved ones close to you who helped you be the person you are today. I have made so many amazing friends and created so many unforgettable memories over the last 3 years. I will take them away into my next chapters of life and cherish them forever. So to finish, all I can say in words of Dr. Seuss, you have the brains in your head, you have your feet in the shoes, you can steer yourself in any direction you choose. Congratulations to everyone here for completing your degree. Enjoy this moment and ensure you all go and celebrate. And above all, good luck, fellow graduates, on your future.
I now invite Mr. Ian Barrow, the Chair of the Board of Governors, to say a few closing remarks.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, distinguished guests, members of the academic procession, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Board of Governors of Leeds Trinity University, it gives me great pleasure to congratulate you, our newest graduates. Today's celebration is an occasion that you will never forget, and rightly so. You have worked very hard for this day and for this moment, and we rightly praise you for your commitment and application. Above all, we applaud you for your success. Nothing succeeds like success. Achievements are like stepping stones, with one leading to another. Your degree represents a significant step forward in your life. It is a very secure step, and it will create opportunities and pathways that may not otherwise have been possible. We are sad to see you leave us today, and saying goodbye is always tinged with sadness. But remember this, the times that you have shared here, the friendships that you have made, and the insights and knowledge that you have gained will always stand you in good stead. These are the ties and experiences that bind. Your days as an undergraduate have come to an end, and we are delighted to welcome you to our alumni community. We hope when you are settled in your career that you may be able to help future generations of students with work placements and internships. I said earlier that success is often self-fulfilling. By choosing to study at Leeds Trinity University, you took a very important step in planning your education and laying the foundations for your career. By graduating today, you have built on this foundation and therefore created more career opportunities for your working life. It is now again up to you to take the next step in your career with the same resolve and determination. On that positive thought, and on behalf of everyone associated with the university, let me again congratulate you on attaining your degree and wish you every success and happiness in the future. I would like to thank Lucy for an excellent vote of thanks on behalf of all the students graduating today. We hope that you have enjoyed your special day and that the memory of your time at Leeds Trinity University will inspire you to even greater achievement. It is now my pleasure to invite you and your guests to join us in the atrium where we'll continue the celebrations with a reception. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the ceremony. Please would you stand for the academic procession?